Welcome to MSBT Online Learning Program, MSBT Lead, Learning at Your Doorstep. I am Mrs. Rita Vora, lecturer in Electronics and Telecommunication Department of Thakur Polytechnic, Mumbai. Dear students, in the first unit of the course, Microcontroller and Applications, we have discussed about the concepts of microprocessor, microcontroller and microcomputer. Thereafter, the types of buses and the types of architecture was discussed. In today's session, we shall discuss the functions of the various pins of the 8051 microcontroller. What will be the learning objective of today's session? State the importance of the 8051 pins. After the session is over, you should be able to answer the question like, explain the functions of the given pins of the 8051 microcontroller. Contents. What all shall be covered in this particular session? The pin diagram of 8051 microcontroller will be shown and the functions of the various pins of 8051 microcontroller will be discussed. The concept map. In the concept map, you can see the pin diagram of the 8051 microcontroller where you can see there are four ports, port 0, port 1, port 2 and port 3. 32 pins out of the 40-pin IC are used up by the four ports. You have the pin number 40, which is the supply voltage of plus 5 volts. Pin number 20 is the ground pin of the 8051 microcontroller. Pin number 9 is the RST pin of the 8051 microcontroller. And the crystal oscillator is connected between the pins 18 and pin number 19. Pin number 29, 30 and 31 are used to access the external memory. Pin diagram of 8051 microcontroller. 8051 is a 40-pin DIPIC. The pin orientation of an 8051 microcontroller may change with the package, but the pin configuration remains the same. This is a detailed diagram of the 8051 40-pin DIPIC. It is a dual inline package and each side contains 20 pins. Let's discuss the pin functions of 8051 microcontroller in detail. VCC, which is pin number 40. VCC provides supply voltage to the chip. The voltage source is plus 5 volts. Pin number 20 is the ground pin, which is connected to the ground. 8051 has on-chip oscillator, but it requires external clock to run it. Unless and until clock is provided to the 8051 microcontroller, it cannot function. Pin number 18 and 19 are the XTAL1 and XTAL2 pins. The external clock can be provided by a quartz crystal or a TTL oscillator. Using a quartz crystal oscillator, the diagram is shown over here. The crystal also needs two capacitors of 30 picofarads for generating a signal of desired frequency. One side of each capacitor, as you can see, is connected to ground. 8051 IC is available in various speeds and it all depends on this quartz crystal. Coming to the RST pin, which is the pin number 9. It is an input pin and is active high. The high pulse must remain high for at least 2 machine cycles. Upon applying a high pulse to the RST, the microcontroller will reset and all the values in the special function registers are reset to their default value, which will be 00 hex for most of the SFRs and it will be 07 hex for the stack pointer. The other RAM contents are also cleared. The power on reset circuit. The diagram here shows a simple power on reset circuit which applies reset signal when it is powered on. Typically the reset circuit comprises of a 8.2 kilo ohm resistor and a 10 microfarad capacitor as can be seen in this diagram. The value of these components are sufficient to provide a delay to make the RST pin high for 2 machine cycles. For the manual reset function, a switch is provided, which can be seen as a dotted part in the diagram. Upon power on or key press, the RST pin goes high And as capacitor charges through the resistor R, the RST signal goes low. This generates active high reset signal for specific time decided by the values of the R and C. It is now time to attend the quiz, which is MCQ set 1. Pin number 31 is the EA bar pin, which is external access. This pin is an active low pin, and upon applying a low pulse, it gets activated. In case of microcontroller 8051 and 52, it has an on-chip ROM, so the EA bar pin is connected to VCC. But in case of 8031 or 8032 microcontroller, which does not have an on-chip ROM, the code is stored in an external ROM and then fetched by the microcontroller. In this case, we must connect the pin number 31 EA bar to ground to indicate that the program code is stored externally. PSEN bar is the pin number 29 and this is the program store enable. This is an output pin and is connected to the output enable pin of the ROM IC. It is an active low signal used to read the external program memory. It is activated every 6 oscillator periods while reading the external program memory. Address latch enable, pin number 30. It is a positive going pulse generated at the rate of 1/6 of the oscillator frequency. It is an output pin and is an active high pin. 8051 port 0 provides both address and data. In case of 8051, the lower order address and data lines are multiplex. The ALE pin is used to demultiplex the address and the data by connecting it to the G pin of the 74LS373 latch. IO port pins. There are 4 ports P0, P1, P2 and P3 in 8051 IC, and each port uses 8 pins. All the IO pins are bidirectional. The 8051 has 4 ports, port 0, port 1, port 2 and port 3. Pins 32 to 39 are the pins of port 0, pins 1 to 8 are the pins of port 1, pins 21 to 28 are the pins for port 2, and pins 10 to 17 are the pins for port 3. Each port has got 8 pins and they can be named as P0.0, which is the bit 0 of port P0. Similarly, P0.7 is the bit 7 of port P0. We can also name the other ports, like P1.0 is the bit 0 of port P1 and P2.0 is the bit 0 of port P2 and so on. These 8 bits, they form a byte. Each port can be used as an input port or an output port, and hence we say they are bidirectional. The pins are configured as an output. That means the logic is 0, and in that case, the single port pins can receive a current of 10 milliamperes. The port 0 and the port 2 pins also have a dual role. Port 0 pins are bidirectional input-output pins, but without any internal pull-up resistors. Hence, we need to add external pull-up resistors in order to use the port 0 pins as input-output port. In addition to acting as the input-output port, port 0 also acts as the lower order address or data bus when the external memory is accessed. Similarly, port 2 is also a bidirectional port. It can function as an input port or an output port, but the additional function of the port 2 is when external memory is interfaced, port 2 pins act as the higher order address byte. Port 2 pins do not need external pull-up resistors as they have internal pull-up resistors available. Alternate functions of port 3. All the port 3 pins have special functions. The following table gives an idea of the details of the additional functions of each pin of port 3. P3.0, which is the pin number 10, its function is serial input. Pin number 11, which is the pin 3.1, is a TXD pin and its function is serial output. Pin number 12, P3.2, is the external interrupt 0 input. Pin number 13, P3.3, is the exon interrupt 1 input. Pin number 14, which is P3.4, it is a timer 0 or the counter 0 external input. Pin number 15, which is P3.5, its function is timer 1, counter 1 external input. Pin number 16 and 17 is the pin 3.6 and P3.7, which is for external data memory write signal and external data memory read signal. So now you should attempt the MCQ set 2. To summarize what we have discussed so far, 8051 microcontroller is a 40-pin dual inline package. These 40 pins serve different functions like read, write, the different input-output operations, interrupts, etc. 8051 has 4 I/O ports wherein each port has 8 pins which can be configured as an input or an output depending upon the logic state of the inputs. Therefore, 32 out of these 40 pins are dedicated to the I/O ports. The rest of the pins are dedicated to the supply VCC, ground, XTAL1, XTAL2, RST, ALE, EA bar and PSEN bar. Thank you.